Don't know. You're mash.
Control organs. Let's have
you
a time debate.
Up.
Let's have a time debate.
So now, next time, listen, you're a little boy.
I'm speaking
to real man like
Jude.
You're a little boy.
Let's do this. Let's have a time debate.
So, Jude, as a Christian, you do not condemn the killing of men, women, children, and babies. Is that yes or no?
Huh? It was during war, and I've told you.
Okay, let me get this right. During war, you do not condemn the killing of men, women, children, and babies.
You condemn it.
Do you condemn Aisha's dad hitting her?
Do you condemn women and children being killed?
Excuse me, what's that got to do with anything? Is that me saying, do you like chocolate
It was
milkshake?
Our first argument, but
No. I know what cameras there fighting and recording. They know who ran away
They're
from what.
They're going to cut it out.
Yeah, you've been running from me since I've been
June, your true colours are coming out, and that's why I'm here today. I told you, I'll give you the good assumption, yeah? I'll give you a good assumption. No, I've never. But when you promote people like DCI, they're rotten with the labels, yeah?
Okay,
so, I'm saying the following, yeah? Let me tell you something, yeah? My point is this, yeah? My point is this, yeah? Now you're a Christian, and you have no way to get out. You, in the Quran, it is haram. It is haram to kill men, women, children, babies. Innocent. Brother, if you leave Christianity, you're killed.
No, I'm not.
Yes, sir.
Haram, why did your prophet
Yes, sir. Just because you don't follow your Bible, it's not your fault.
Why did your prophet
my point is the following.
Kids, why did your prophet permit?
My point is the following, yeah? That in the Quran, it is haram to cut trees, kill men, innocent women, children, and babies.
Yeah, so did your
In
prophet.
The Bible, it
like
listen. It's a direct commandment.
You're done,
you go and kill the Amalekites.
That is how he's took the mic.
Men, women, children, and babies.
Yeah, I know. He's
so imagine,
like, you just want to talk to
imagine me as a Muslim saying I condone killing babies. But I'll be in Guantanamo Bay.
Your prophet does.
Send me to Guantanamo Bay in 2 seconds.
Your prophet does.
But when a Christian, yeah, when a Christian says in a war, babies can be killed, right?
In war.
Yeah, look at him, bro, so casually.
Yeah,
babies, man! Crying babies!
Said the same thing here.
Sorry, Muslim.
It says babies there.
1745. Yes. It was authority of Shah of Jaffa, that a prophet of Allah, when asked about the women and children, when the polytheists being killed during the night raid, said, they are from them.
Simple.
Good night, we're done
here.
Collateral damage. Brothers and sisters.
Yeah, we don't know.
We're direct.
Women and children asleep at night.
So,
your prophet was a demon.
The point is this, guys, yeah?
June,
you can no way, shape, or form ever come and question Islam again. You know why? Because you live in a glass house. So when you live in a glass house, June, and you promote people like DCCI, whatever they're called, yeah? You have no legs to stand on. And if you're going to reject Islam, and Islam is not moral because of the Prophet Muhammad, you can say bye-bye to your God. Say this, do this to Jesus.
Why?
Because the Book of Numbers. Book of Numbers, yeah?
Woman,
okay, did he? Show me one false prophecy. Go on, show me one false prophecy. You get drowned in that, bruv. You get drowned in these things, yeah?
In what?
Okay, you're going to find out now.
In what?
Yeah, in what?
God said a movie.
Inshallah.
Who said a movie?
We're going to find out now.
For his question.
This is why, that's what I'm saying, yeah? We as Muslims, we always assume the best. And I do not regret assuming the best in him, ever. Ever.
Really?
But the point is this,
since
yeah?
You've seen the
when the true colours come out, we'll
Where's
show them to the world.
He attacked me. You're gone. Made a
critique. No, you didn't make a critique. You lied and you attacked
didn't
Islam.
Lie.
Yes, you did.
This is
yes,
Islam right now.
Show
yeah?
me the first prophecy.
Give me the mic if you want me to be ready.
Show me the first prophecy.
Give me the mic. I'll read it out to you.
So now let me ask you guys a question. Which is going to put all of you mans in one seat.
I'll expose your prophet.
How did the Quran know that the Romans, the Prophet says that the Romans got defeated by the Persians very badly? The Quran prophesizes that in a matter of 3 to 9 years that the Romans are going to be defeated. How did he make that prophecy? How did it know?
I don't know about that one.
Go on, little boy, you've gone silent.
What?
Go on.
What am I supposed to say?
Nothing.
Right. No, give me the mic. Give me the mic. I'll show you.
Ali, why have you taken
narrated,
the mic?
Narrated, Sahih Bukhari, 29:39.
Why have you taken the mic,
Allah's Messenger said that the hour will not be established until you fight with the Jews. And the stone behind which a Jew will be hiding will say, oh, Muslim,
so now,
there was
me,
a Jew hiding
me,
behind me,
how did the
so
know that?
Kill him.
Actually, you know what? I've got
a bunch of anti-Semites.
I've got a better one. Check this out.
I've got more. Your prophet said
check
to kill us.
In the Bible,
sorry, Muslim, 15
in the Bible,
Allah's messenger,
about the ruler
has to kill dogs.
As
and we carried out this order.
Did you know that?
So that Mark,
in the Bible, Joseph, the ruler of Joseph, is called a pharaoh.
Coming with
and in the Moses, because it's a big time gap between
them. What did the dogs do? What did the dogs do?
So,
Ali, ask the question.
So, in the Bible, when it talks about the ruler at the time of Joseph, it calls him a pharaoh. At the time of Moses, it calls him a pharaoh. Guess what? They say the Quran copied the Bible, yeah? Then why didn't the Quran copy this? Because in the Quran, it says the ruler at the time of Joseph is a king. And the ruler at the time of Moses is a pharaoh. So one second. When they discovered the Rosetta Stone and they deciphered the hieroglyphics, they found out at the time of Joseph,
we'll ask you questions,
there was no pharaohs.
You're not engaging with me.
How did the Quran know that?
You keep running. Why did you keep
running? How did they find out?
Why do you keep running?
June, how did the Quran know that?
We actually have a debate.
June, how did the Quran know that? June, one second. June, how did the Quran correct the mistake the Bible made?
What mistake?
In the Bible, it says at the time of Joseph, the ruler is a pharaoh, and at the time of Moses, the pharaoh. That's a historical error. When they discovered the Rosetta Stone,
Did the moon split?
What's that got to do with anything?
Did the moon split?
Bob, I'm asking simple questions.
Simple question. Quran says the moon split.
Why does it call the ruler a pharaoh when no pharaohs existed?
Nobody saw the moon split.
Can you answer my question? Can you answer my question? Please, can you answer my question, Jim? It's a historical error. Historians will laugh at you. There was no pharaoh.
When he goes to the Bible.
No. Ask
him. When he asked me a question, I can't.
No. So tell me, how did the Quran correct the mistake of the Bible?
Didn't correct any mistake.
So, okay, why does it call the ruler pharaoh at the time of Joseph? This is a false. In Egypt, but there was no pharaohs.
Don't ask his question because he ain't answering us.
Stop shaking.
Yeah, stop being ugly. And answer the question.
You wish you
answer
like,
the question.
You wish you like,
answer your prophet. I'm going to read this out.
Hater, don't hate me because he
is reported on the authority of Abu Huraira that the Messenger of Allah said,
I've
been commanded to fight against the people so long as.
Why did the Quran correct the mistake of the Bible?
And he who professed it was guaranteed the protection.
So in the ruler it says it's about Pharaoh. There was no pharaohs at that time.
Except for the rights of the rest of Allah.
There was no pharaohs
commanded the killing
at the time of Joseph.
Do not believe him. Night.
Yes, because it didn't exist at that time.
You're addressing these points.
No, that's the point. The Quran calls them king. The Bible calls them pharaoh. It's a historical error.
When was the book written?
Which book?
The one you're quoting.
This was talking about the Bible. We're talking about after Jesus.
Yeah.
2,000 years ago. But you don't have the original manuscript. That's a different story. You have, let's say, 2,000 years ago. The rulership of Joseph is going maybe 4,000 years. So how did the Quran copy from the Bible and correct this mistake? Can you answer my question? Can you answer my question? No, answer my question. June, answer my question. June, you said the Quran has false prophecies. How did the Quran correct the mistake of the Bible?
The Quran didn't correct anything, just gave it a different name.
Historically, there was no pharaohs at the time of Joseph. The Quran calls them king. So the Quran is given a right term for the dynasty of that time. So why did the Bible get it wrong? It's the word of God.
Yes, yeah, the word of your God, and I'll prove it. Come and listen to me. I'll prove it. It's the word of your God.
The Bible says they went to
Pharaoh. Tafsir hadith.
So you are a Christian, and you're following a book that has errors, and you have no answers.
Yeah, it was the
and you're here questioning Islam.
Was the moose split in the 7th century?
We do have answers.
What's your answer? What's your answers? What's your answers?
We've given you the answers.
What's your answers?
Three questions you've asked.
You didn't. I went to all of them.
Let me go to the
I went to the book of Numbers. I went to the book of Numbers. I went to apostasy. You started with Aisha's marriage. I went to the book of Numbers. You started with apostasy. I went to the book of Exodus. Yeah? You went to about killing verses. I went to the book of Samuel.
This is your apology, a dishonest prick. That's your
Exodus,
a dishonest prick.
Samuel, and the book of Numbers.
Don't respect this guy. He's been running from me since day one. Since I stepped there.
How did the Bible not know that mistake?
All of us missed that vision.
All right, answer it.
Say
no, you haven't.
What, stand here
you haven't answered it.
The
guy's been
it's a false prophecy.
Me a little boy.
We're not talking about that.
I am. You said prophecies. The Quran has false prophecies. Yeah. I just gave you one.
But now,
and I'll give you another one.
Allah be with you. May Allah.
Allah's dead, man.
Why are you running away from the original question?
I'm not. You said false prophecies. I'm going to false prophecies.
In the Bible, ask I said about Muhammad.
Excuse me. You said false prophecy. How did the Quran know it? How did the Quran call it king, but the Bible makes it wrong because of Pharaoh?
I looked into the paradise.
Yes. Historically correct.
How did poor people, and I looked into hellfire and found that the majority of its dwellers,
Pharaoh and king are two separate dynasties.
The majority of people in hell.
Excuse me. There was no pharaohs at the time of Joseph.
That's why Muslim.
Do you understand? There was no pharaohs.
Leave Islam.
Leave your wicked religion and turn to Jesus Christ.
Come to Jesus.
Yeah, answer, you got a mic. Hold it close.
Who's Tutankhamun?
I don't know who's Tutankhamun.
I've got so much more. I've got so much more in this guy's
book. No. You don't understand. The time of Joseph, there was no such things as.
engaged. Your friend, you said.
My friend. Do you know what engaged is?
Bribe to Muhammad.
Engaged is marriage.
That's not just engaged.
One second.
Engaged is marriage.
Abu Bakr.
Engaged is marriage.
So why did he divorce her?
My friend. It's engaged marriage.
After her, that's
No. My friend, you don't talk about Islam without knowing. Yeah? You're here. Listen. You learn about Islam. You learn about Islam, yeah? You're getting your sources from 8 preachers, and that's why we're exposing you. You're getting exposed today, Jews. You're getting exposed. You're getting exposed. Because as a Christian, you must be mad to come and question us about Islam. You must be mad. You must be mad. That's why your little dogs here are dying. That's why they're dying. They're burning. That's why. That's the burning. Very simple. Very simple. She was proposed to, and she proposed to. Call it engaged. Yes. She was not married.
Is engaged.
She was not married. No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. Excuse me. Just because someone is engaged doesn't mean they're married.
So if she was engaged,
Abu Bakr. Yes, but
was
not married.
She divorced?
No, she was not. How can you be divorced if engaged? No. Yeah. Firstly, number one, you need to first show me the authentication of that. Where is that? Number two, what is your point?
Your forefather Abu Bakr.
What's it? Her being married before is good for me. Because it shows that at those times it was the norm.
Oh, it's good for a child to be married according to you.
Exactly. So I'm saying to you.
Do you condone a child being married before?
Excuse me.
This guy's a pedophile.
Do you condone that?
Would you marry a fool?
Excuse me. Listen carefully. Listen to me. Listen to me carefully. Yeah? Because you're going to get exposed today like a little boy you are. Yeah? Yeah? You're getting exposed today. Yeah? You're a hate preacher who promotes people like them, and you're getting exposed. Yeah?
With that beard, bro.
Betrothed. It's betrothed
like
marriage.
Huh?
It's betrothed marriage.
You didn't say betrothed.
One second. One second.
You brought an Arabic reader who said, sir.
Does getting betrothed mean marriage?
Have you seen yourself in here?
Does betrothed mean marriage?
No.
I didn't say anything to him.
He's saying he's annoying.
One second, man. One second. In William Blackstone's book, in the comment, in Baba, please. William Blackstone's book, in the UK, this country, yeah, 100 years ago, girls were allowed to be betrothed at 7, yeah? Pedophile country, yeah?
So?
In France, let me tell you something.
June,
if you was a middle-aged man, you fit the profile of a pedophile more than the Prophet Muhammad.
He says he's the best example.
Most pedophiles are white middle-aged men.
That's what your prophet
so
says.
So if you have a concern about pedophiles, June,
June,
if you have an issue, if you have an issue with pedophiles, you have to start a campaign because your church, whatever, do you know how many dead bodies were found in churches of boys being abused? Yeah? But your religion,
why are we going off the
one second?
He's not shaking.
Guys, in churches they're finding dead bodies of boys being abused.
No.
Bruv, when you talk about pedophiles, the first thing that comes to anyone's mind is a white middle-aged man, if he was a bit older, that looks like you.
White middle-aged
man.
So what did he do?
If you have an issue with pedophiles,
pedophile.
My friend, you are a danger to girls more than I could ever be. Yes, exactly. Exactly.
What kind of logic is this? Please,
let's look at pedophiles.
Tell me, with sense.
Let's look at.
If anybody disagrees with having sex with an 9-year-old girl,
watch
they're
this.
Honestly worse than a pedophile.
No, him. Not them.
This guy's annoying.
Ali.
Seriously.
Can you look at this hadith?
Honestly,
hadith
he's been strung up on the neck. I'm being honest.
About the Aisha and her, that she was married before. I knew that she was promised to someone.
But she wasn't saying. You were last, man.
Can you read it? Open it.
Why are we acting up like that, bro?
Okay, but can you read?
Mansoor, come in. You should be ashamed of your
guys,
prophet.
Go to Google. Go to Google and write pedophiles.
Muhammad is the biggest example.
Can you zoom in, Baba? Can you zoom in, please?
Wow, that's so racist.
Zoom in, Bob.
Muhammad is the biggest.
Zoom in, Bob. I'm going to bury you today.
How's that man?
Why are you racist?
That's what your prophet look like. Your prophet look like these men. Your prophet is a back-end pedophile.
We are talking about prophet here.
Check this out.
Your prophet tends to be the best example for mankind.
Check this out.
Yeah, he seems annoying, bro.
Does that look like a Muslim, bro?
Yeah, all them look like Muslims. They all look like Muhammad.
What was Muhammad?
The first Muslim, apparently.
They are
Ali.
All
Ali, what was Muhammad?
Where is
that look like a Muslim,
what is Muhammad?
What is Muhammad?
All I did was, look, check this out. Go to Google. What did
run
I write?
Again, run it.
Did I write white pedophile? Did I write white pedophile? But man wrote pedophile.
He went on Google.
The algorithm
took some images of
pedophiles.
Therefore, it's right for people to have sex with little girls. The logic is astounding.
Let me show you pedophile here.
So now let me wrap up. You see guys in the park, we try to assume
this guy's such a narcissist, please. Do not follow Muslims believing in the truth.
We assume the best.
Jesus Christ is the Lord. He's the way, the truth, and the life. This guy's a demon.
This is called pedophile.
This guy's a demon, bro.
I'm going to do a little prophecy. Now, let me tell you guys something, yeah?
Pedophile here.
You see,
guys? This is pedophile here.
When people come to the park,
this is pedophile here.
They want some attention. We give them attention.
See you. This is Islamic pedophile. Here is a pedophile. Here is a pedophile. Here is a pedophile. Here is a pedophile.
With a little dab. That was a halal one, of course. Now you see them walking off with their tails behind their legs. Let me tell you guys something, yeah? This little boy, June, he came to the park. He was keep looking at me. I was here, I was keep looking. And I thought, what's the deal? I talked to him. He was a Satanist. Anyways. So I thought, look, let's talk to him. Then he started moving mad. Next week he rings me. I gave him my number. I said, look, let's go. He rings me and he goes, yeah, I insulted the prophet. I was angry. I'm sorry. I said, okay, look. It's wrong what you did. I assume the best. Next thing I know, my man comes, accepts Christianity. No problem. There's nothing wrong with accepting Christianity. He starts following DCCI, who come and drill the Quran, who rip the Quran, who insult the Prophet. He starts following David Wood, Rotten Wood, Apus, and all the enemies of Islam, and Christian Princess, yeah? The question I was asking is, why would he do that? And then he said to me, he goes, I want to criticize Islam. And I thought, why don't you want to criticize Christianity or Judaism? Why Islam? Why Islam? Then I started noticing that he is starting to move a bit funny. I still assume the best. Last week, me and Hijab talked to him. Then he's promoting them on his channel and he releases a video about Quran being corrupted. So I thought, bro, this guy's a charlatan. So I came today to have a discussion with him. What did he do? Automatically goes to the Aisha's marriage. Brother, if you're rejecting Islam because of the promised marriage to Aisha, you have to say bye-bye to your God of the Old Testament. Because in the Old Testament, Jesus claims, he says, go and get little girls who are virgins and keep them for yourself. So he came to me with apostasy. Bro, go to the book of Exodus. It says kill, if they apostate, children and kids. Then he came to me with killing men, women, children. I said, bro, go to the book of Samuel. Kill men, women, children, babies and donkeys. He said to me, oh, Islam has false prophecies. I gave him two prophecies to shut his mouth. The point is this, guys. This side to me only comes out to the enemies of Islam. I'm calm, I'm reasonable, I have a nice discussion. But when you start coming and acting like this and insulting the prophet, bruv, I wrote pedophile on Google. All of them mans look like you. They look like you. So if you're going to come to me about pedophilia, the biggest pedophiles are white middle-aged men. I'm not saying all white men are like that. My point is this. If your issues with pedophilia, you need to start an organization, and most of the people that you're going to target are white middle-aged men. They go into Australia now, Africa, to rape little kids. Go to the church. You know how many dead bodies they're finding now of kids being sexually abused and killed? So don't come to me chatting nonsense. So as you can see, they got buried, all of them together, and that is exactly what we'll do. So Islam is not a pacifist religion like, hey, throw roses, yeah? If we see you're hostile, we'll let you know what time it is. And that's what we did to this little boys, yeah? So till next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Is this ours? Thank you, brothers.
Brothers and sisters, Allahu Akbar, thanks to your tremendous support, we have, alhamdulillah, paid the final installment for this huge masjid property, and now we need your support to convert this 2,700 square meters building into the most amazing Islamic center in the country of Norway, inshallah.
But bro, this does not look like a masjid, it looks like a wedding hall.
And that's exactly what this is. Brothers and sisters, we need your support to reconstruct this wedding hall into a masjid and community center so we can have our prayer hall for us to establish salah 5 times a day, an indoor playground for the kids to nurture love for the house of Allah, a conference hall for lectures and reminders about Islam.
We need classrooms for education, a library to study, a gym for exercise, and a soup kitchen to help the poor and needy.
If you support us, even with a small sadaqah, you will inshallah harvest a reward for all of these facilities and the khayr that they generate throughout the years, all the way until the day we meet Allah.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever builds a masjid for the sake of Allah, Allah will build for him a similar house in Jannah. So what are you waiting for? Click the button to donate and share the video for extra rewards.